In the previous class, shortly explained with the help of live example, KMR madam engaged in the class probability class between 2 to 3. Now I am going to take the original statement of Bayes' theorem. The statement is if an event A, instead of KMR madam engaged in the class is nothing, but if an event A can only occur in conjunction, means intersection, conjunction. Conjunction with one of the n mutually exclusive and exhaustive events, even U2, etc. n, they take an n events instead of what 60 students, they take an n students, and if A actually happens, then the probability that it was preceded by the particular event may be EI, may be 1 to N, because here they consider N events, is given by probability of EI slash A is nothing but probability of EI into probability of A slash EI divided by summation I ranging from how many events taken 1 to 10, probability of EI into probability of A slash EI. This is a statement of general statement of Bayes' rule or Bayes' theorem. If an event A, A is nothing but KMR madam engaged in the class, can only occur in conjunction is intersection with one of n mutually exclusive and exhaustive events, they consider n events. If A actually happens, means class is going on, then the probability that it was preceded by the particular event A is given by probability of EI slash A is nothing but P of EI into probability of A slash EI divided by summation I ranging from O to N, P of EI into P of A slash EI. The proof is not explained based on the KMR madam is engaged in the class like the Tony related proof. The proof is very simple. They given in the statement, what is the statement they given? A can occur in conjunction. A can occur only in conjunction with one of n mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. Therefore, A can be written as A intersection A1 or A intersection A2 or maybe A intersection of EN. An event A can only occur in conjunction with one of n mutually exclusive and exhaustive event. At least either A occur with E1 or E2 or E3 or EN. At least one must be happen. Then I want to find out what is the probability of A. What is the probability of A? Probability of A is nothing but probability of A intersection E1 union of A intersection E2 union of etc. A intersection of EN. Okay, fine. Now, they given very clearly A can occur only in conjunction with one of N mutually exclusive. Therefore, E1, E2, E3 cannot be occur simultaneously. From the addition theorem, this can be written as probability of A intersection E1 plus probability of A intersection E2 etc. Plus etc. probability of A intersection EN. Okay. This is nothing but probability of A. But what we given? A cannot be happen independently. A can be happen along with any one of the mutually exclusive events, say E1, E2, E3, etc. Therefore, A cannot be, from multiplication theorem, they have product of their probability or anyone they may be depending. A is not independent. A is dependent on E1 because A can occur only in conjunction with any one of mutually exclusive events, E1, E2, E3, etc. Therefore, from the multiplication theorem, this can be written as E1 happen first, then only A happening based on E1. Because even A can occur only in mutually exclusive and exhaustive of any events. Therefore, P of E2 into P of A slash E2, etc. The last one is nothing but En happened, then only A happening. Okay. Suppose you combining all of the terms together, suppose you write it in the form of summation, that is nothing but P of I into P of A slash Ei for I ranging from 1 to n. This is nothing but the probability of A, the event A occur only in conjunction with intersection with one of n mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. Based on that, we get this P of A. After that, they given very clearly in the statement, just now I read out the statement. Just now I read out the statement. What is this? Is the first part. If A is an event, can only occur in conjunction with one of n mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. Based on that, we get this. But I move to the second half. If A actually happen, if A actually happens, then the probability that it was preceded by the particular event Ei means A already happened, it was particularly preceded by the event. I want to find out that. Before I'm going to write that part, okay. Now, I'm going to write what is probability of A intersection Ei. What's the probability of A intersection Ei? You already know that. That part just now we explained. That is nothing but probability of, probability of A intersection Ei. A cannot be happen independently. This can also be written as probability of, absolutely, probability of Ei intersection A I am going to write. Please try to understand, this is a one of the important things we have to require here. This is different. What is that actually? This is we are taking later. Okay, this is clear. What is another half of that? If A actually happens, then the property that it was preceded by the particular event, say Ei. A happened, then only I want to find out what's the probability of Ei based on A. Because A happened actually, then it was that, then I have to find out the probability that it was preceded by the particular event Ei. Means probability of the particular student is given answer in KMR class is nothing but, this can be written as probability of Ei intersection A divided by probability of A from the which theorem? Multiplication theorem. From the multiplication theorem. Here also we used multiplication theorem. Now, this is, but A cannot be, now we are observably, A cannot be happened. E happened when only A happening. Therefore, probability of E of Ei into probability of A slash Ei divided by, we already know that what is probability of A is nothing but P of Ei into probability of A slash Ei for I ranging from 1 to n. This is nothing but the proof of Bayes rule or Bayes theorem. The proof of Bayes rule or Bayes theorem. Now if you want to zoom out for this, then easy to understand what is our Bayes rule. I'm showing the entire statement and proof in one screenshot. Observe carefully. Don't confuse. This is a very, very important. Now it's clear. Once you go to my previous video, definitely you are understanding this, what is our Bayes rule or Bayes theorem. Now, this statement of Bayes rule, if an event A can only occur in conjunction with, conjunction with one of n mutually exclusive and exhaustive events, say even it is a union events they taken, and if A actually happens in the property that it was preceded by the particular event, say EA, maybe an E1 or E2, E3 or EN is given by this. First you take first part, A can only occur in conjunction means intersection with one of N mutually exclusive, A happen with E1 or happen with E2, happen with EN. At least happening along with anyone. Therefore, I have to take union. But happening of E1, E2, E3 are mutually exclusive. From the once you find out the probability, from the addition theorem we get sum. But A cannot be happen because A happen only conjunction with E1, E2, etc. Therefore, E1 happening, E1 happened, then only A happening. Therefore, from the multiplication theorem we get this. And then if you want to write sum of n terms in the summation form. Next, move to the half of the part. If A actually happens, then the probability that it was preceded by the particular event AI. See, A already happened, then you find out what's the particular event preceded by A. Means probability of AI slash A. From the multiplication theorem, this can be written as because you know probability of A intersection B. Suppose A dependent on B means B probability of B into probability of A slash B. From this, what is probability of A slash B is nothing but probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B. Like that, we get this. And this, but A cannot be happen independently. A is mutually exclusive depending with AI for I1 to N. Therefore, for A from multiplication theorem we get. Then you substitute P of A, that gives us a proof of what base rule or base theorem. I think this is clear based on previous video and this video. Now before I'm going to wind up, at least I'll solve one problem in this class. Okay. Now I'll move to another problem. Okay. Now we wind up to solve one problem in this class. Okay. Yeah. I'm going to write the statement for that. Problem. Simple problem going to take. In the next class, I'm going to discuss few more problems. Okay. Now, the problems. First, the problem is, yeah. First problem, I'm going to take that. The probabilities that A, B, C hit a target are respectively 1/6, 1/4, and 1/3. Yeah. Each shoots one at the target. Find the probability that exactly one of them hits the target. If only one hits the target, what is the probability that it was A? Yeah, observe carefully for this problem. The probabilities of hitting a target for ABC, they given 1 by 6, 1 by 4, 1 by 3 respectively. You choose one at a time at the target. Each shoots one at the target. Find the probability that exactly one of them hits the target. If I want to find the probability that exactly one of them hits the target, if only one hits the target, what is the probability it was A? First, what are the things they given? First, you write it in the problem. What they given? They give probability of let. Now, for my convenience, I am going to take that E be hitting the target. Yeah. Everyone hitting the target now. Therefore, I am taking the E denotes hitting the target. They already mentioned A, B, C, it's a target. Therefore, probability of A, they given 1 by 6. Probability of B, they given 1 by 4. Probability of C is nothing but 1 by 3 they given. Okay. Now, this is a very, very important. Now, they each choose one at the target. Find the probability that exactly one of them is the target. What before that, what they given? Each choose one at the time. One at the target. Each shoots one at the target. Find the probability that exactly one of them hits the target. Okay. It is enough to find out here probability of hitting the target. Find the probability that exactly one of them hits the target. Means I want to find out P of E first. How to find out? The exactly one of them hit the target, either A is the target or B is the target, C maybe is the target. Then it is possible to find the probability that exactly one of them is the target. Therefore, E, at least one must be happen. I have to take union. Now, I want to find out P of E. What is my P of E? P of E is nothing but, P of E is nothing but, please try to understand. This is one of a tricky problem. It's nothing but what actually? Probability of this. But, hitting the target of A, B, C, they are not dependent, they are independent. See, observe equally. Probability of A intersection A union this, at least one must be happen. Occurring, see, A happen, A hit the target. Because at the time, exactly one of them hit the target. A hit the target, you can't say that B hit the target, C hit the target. Therefore, all three are not happening simultaneously. From the addition theorem, all are mutually exclusive. This can be written as sum of the probabilities. Okay. From this theorem, addition theorem. Okay, fine. Now, I move to the next step. The next step is actually what actually here? Very simple. Next step is hitting the target and then this. See, absolutely, if we hit the target means the person must be there, then only he is going to hit the target. So, for probability of which one is happening, A happen, then only E happening. Hitting the target means person must be there, then only is going to hit the target. Therefore, probability of B into probability of E slash A, B. Similarly, probability of C into probability of E slash C. Please try to understand, hitting the target means the person must be there, then only is going to hit the target. Otherwise, there is no question is arise to A is hitting the target. From the multiplication theorem, now we get this. But I want to write what's the probability of A hitting the target, B is hitting the target and C is hitting the target. What's the probability of hitting the target from A? What's the probability of hitting the target from B? What's the probability of hitting the target from C? But they give each shoes one at a time. Therefore, the probability of E slash A must be equal to probability of E slash B, and also probability of E slash C must be equal to 1 by 3. They are equally likely events because there are 3 events are there. Each one shoots one at target once at the time. Therefore, what's the probability of E slash A, E slash B and E slash C is 1 by 3. Now, I have to substitute these 3 in the problem. What we get, this is 1 by 6 into 1 by 3, 1 by 4 into 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 into 1 by 3. Simplify that. Now we have to simplify this, then we get the answer for first question. You simplify that. Take LCM and simplify that. Take LCM is 24 and then simplify that. Now you get actually 18 divided by 24 is the answer. 18 divided by 24 is the answer. Okay. Yeah. I'll move to the next one. It's the last one. Okay. In the last one, actually, what if only one hit the target? What is the probability that it was A? It was A. First hitting the target, after that we observe who is hitting the target? A. That is from A. Therefore, hitting this comes, A comes later. Therefore, what we are going to do? What we are going to find out here? It is enough to find out here actually probability of which one actually? A slash E. Hitting the target comes first and then A. See, if the target, after that who is hitting the target, we observe that is probability of A slash E. What is probability of A slash E? Is nothing but probability of A into probability of E slash A divided by sum of that probability of A into probability of E slash A plus probability of B, these are comes in denominator, into probability of B slash A plus probability of C into probability of this is actually E slash B probability of C into probability of E slash C. Okay, now we have all the values, substitute, simplify that. We get final answer for this is 2 by 9. Yeah, I'm going to leave that part. Please try to understand. This is very simple. I explain very clearly. See, now I want to find a probability of exactly one of them eating. Either A eating or B eating or C eating. At least one must be eating the target. Therefore, now what we are going to do here, it is enough to find out the probability of, please try to understand, this is one of the important thing we are observe carefully here. This is a thing just now I explained for this, yeah, observe carefully for this part. Now just now I explained this, is very easy to understand for this part, yeah. Two by nine is the answer, okay. Everything is jumbled here. Just now I explained. First you find out the probability of E. Either occur along with A with B, with C. At least one must be happen. Therefore, what I return from the multiplication theorem, I return probability of A intersection with mean of that. Some of their probability, because A intersection is happening, you can't expect it to at a time only one, you can't expect B and C some of them. But A happened, then only hitting the target is happening. Therefore, now I have to go for multiplication theorem, you get this. Okay. And then you substitute R. I explain what is the probability of E slash A, probability of E slash B. Equally weighted means what is that probability is 1/3. Yeah. So hitting the target from A, hitting the target from B, from C, all are equally weighted because they given each shoots one at the target. Therefore 1/3. Therefore now substitute and simplify. I told final answer after the substitute this value is nothing but 18/24. But next, if only one hits the target, what is the probability that it was A? It was A means hitting the target is first. And then that hit the, see, first you observe who is anybody are hitting the target. Yeah, hit the target. After that try to observe who is hit the target. Who is that? A. That is A slash E is nothing but probability of A into probability of E slash A divided by sum of the probability of A into probability of E slash A plus probability of B into E slash C B and then probability of C into probability of E slash C. Okay. Now these values you have to substitute. The P of A is 1/6, this is 1/3, equal by 3. Then 1/6 into 1/3. Next, they already know 1/4, 1/3. 1/3 into 1/3. Simplify that. Finally, we get 2/9 is the answer. This is the probability hitting the target. It was hit by A. This is the way I have to solve the problem. Now, I am showing entire the problem in one screenshot. Observe carefully. Okay? Yeah. This is where I have to write the answer. Now I am coming back few more problems in the next class. Okay. See, problems arises in between that due to my dizzy board. Please give me excuse for that. Even though after that I explain once again entire thing. Okay. First you find the probability of E and then you find the probability of A slash. Instead of a probability it was A, it was B, it was C also. You try for that. Probability of A, B slash E, probability of C slash E. You try that and giving the exercise for that. Probability of B slash E and then probability of C slash E. Using the same basis, see, base rule only they give answer for this question. Therefore, base rule is a very hard, very core, important concept. Please try to understand that. Thank you very much for visiting my video. Please come back next video. I am going to take few more problems in my next video. Okay? Thank you. Bye. See you and take care.